Christian Audio, a division of Recorded Books, presents A Very Big Problem by Amy Jill Levine and Sandy Eisenberg Sasso. Narrated by Lisa Larsen. Publisher's note: the print and ebook versions of this book include illustrations by Annie Bowler. God planted the very first garden in the whole world. You might think it was a quiet and peaceful place, but it wasn't. There was a problem, a very big problem. Each part of the garden was sure it was the best, the most important, the one God loved more than any other. They all bragged and boasted and blustered. Land said, "God made me first. I was here before any of you. Without me, there would be no garden, no place for seeds to take root, or vegetables to grow, or flowers to bloom. I am the first." Land quaked. God should love me the most. It is only fair. Rain sputtered. "No way is that fair. Without me, nothing could grow. What good is land without rain? Nothing more than dusty dirt. I am the most refreshing." Rain drizzled. "God should love me the most. It is only fair." Plants sprouted. "No way is that fair. We may have come after land and rain, but what is a garden without us? Just an empty field. No bright colors, no sweet scents, no soft grass. We are the most beautiful." Plants bloomed. "God should love us the most. It is only fair." Sun blazed. "No way is that fair. Without me, land and rain just make mushy mud. Plants have no energy to grow. A garden can't live in the dark. I am the brightest." Sun beamed. "God should love me the most. It is only fair." Birds squawked. "No way is that fair. Without us, there is no garden. We carry plant seeds from one place to another. We give land what it needs to grow grass and trees, vegetables and flowers. Our songs are the most splendid." Birds tweeted, "God should love us the most. It is only fair." Earthworms wriggled. "No way is that fair. Without our squiggling and wiggling underground, without our turning the earth, rain will wash away, land will erode. Sun can't feed birds, but we can. We are the busiest." Earthworms squirmed. "God should love us the most. It is only fair." Quadrupeds, all the four-legged critters, trotted and ran and hopped. "No way is that fair." The elephants trumpeted. "We're the biggest." The cheetahs growled. "We're the fastest." The rabbits thumped. "We're the cutest." They all cheered. "God should love us the most." And then children came along. "No fair, no fair, no fair. No way is that fair. Without us, there is no one to care for the garden. We till it and feed it and rake it and weed it. You all may have been created before us, but we are the most important. We are the best of creation, the very best." The children cried, "God should love us the most. It is only fair." God listened to land and rain, plants and sun, birds and earthworms, quadrupeds and children, and smiled. Then God said, "Some of you came before others. Some of you are bigger, and some are stronger. Some sing, and some growl. Some wiggle, and some thump. But all of you are needed. My love is big enough for every one of you. Without all of you together, there would be no garden at all." Land and rain, plants and sun, birds and earthworms, quadrupeds and children, everyone listened to what God said. They stopped arguing. They stopped bragging and boasting and blustering. In one raucous chorus, they sang.
We hope you enjoyed this preview. To continue listening to this audiobook on Google Play Books, use the link in the video description.